According to system generalizations, when we are approaching the patient that is unconscious during the advanced life support, yes, we will do the advanced life support, but when we try to figure out why the patient is undergoing a systole, pulse electrical activity, ventricular tachycardia without pulse, or ventricular fibrillation, mainly a systole or ventricular tachycardia, we will try to figure out the cause as the H's and P's. So, well, H and T's. The disturbance can be caused by hypoglycemia, hypo or hyperkalemia, hyponatremia, hypovolemia, and hypoxia. Now the T's, we have thrombosis, either arterial or venous thrombosis, tension pneumothorax, tamponade, and toxins. Here we're talking about a drug overdose like opioids or something like that. So we need to think about any one of these causes and try to figure it out. Other generalization is we, most of the time, we give bicarbonate to the patient that is, for example, on pulsed electrical activity, and we already run the protocol of the 5 cycles of 30 compressions, 2 breaths, but with all the 5 cycles and 5 cycles, 5 cycles, with the alternation with epinephrine and amiodarone, so that would be like 3 cycles, and remember that between one epinephrine and another epinephrine, we have like 3 to 5 minutes. We are talking about 2 cycles of five, two, let's say, two times we do 5 cycles of CPR here. So if we're going to give 3 doses of epinephrine, here I did these 2 times 5 cycles, and here I usually have already done before 2 times 5 cycles. Here I could do 2 times 5 cycles, so 1, 2, 3, 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4 times 2, 8 times 5 cycles. So it would be 40 cycles. All right. So after we have run the protocol, so giving the 3 doses of epinephrine, we usually give bicarbonate to the patient because the patient going on asystole is probably getting lactic acidosis. So we will give bicarbonate. Also, bicarbonate can correct some disturbances of the potassium, and also some toxins like antidepressant overdose or aspirin. The only way that we're not going to give bicarbonate could be some induced acidosis. Other thing is the post-resuscitative care. Here is, we usually try to get the patient between 32 and 34 degrees Fahrenheit. So we are cooling the patient. We would cooling the patient with either blankets, fluids, or ice. And this needs to be done within the 6 hours of the event and lasts for 12 to 24 hours. The only exception, that is when this is contraindicated, is in patients that they have induced hypothermia.